Alrighty, let's talk about the integumentary system. So the integumentary system consists of your skin, your hair, and your nails. All of those structures provide protection. And then the skin, as we will see in the rest of these pages, is composed of subdivisions, layers. The top layer of your skin is called the epidermis. And if you recall from our tissue discussion, the epidermis is composed of keratinized, stratified squamous epithelial tissue. Then below or deep to your epidermis is the dermis. The dermis is the thick portion of your skin. Inside the dermis, you have sweat glands and nerves and blood vessels and hair follicles. All of those reside in the dermis. And then the tissue surrounding the dermis is mostly dense, irregular connective tissue. Then deep to the dermis is the hypodermis, which is mostly adipose connective tissue. So now you're seeing why it's important that we talk about tissue early on in the semester so that when we get to each of these organ systems, you're comfortable discussing the different tissue types within the system. Now, the primary function of the integumentary system is definitely protection. It protects your body from stressors like UV light, like mechanical stressors, any kind of abrasion, lacerations. So there's a layer on the outside, as we'll see, the epidermis, that's extremely protective. And even that underlying layer, the dermis, is also protective as well. We also need to be protected from pathogens. When we get to the immune system, which is also in this unit, we will see that there are components to the skin that are antimicrobial. There are also cells in the skin that provide protection against pathogens. Now, another function of the integumentary system is body temperature regulation. All of the capillaries in our skin can vasodilate or vasoconstrict. For example, when we're hot and we need to release heat, our dermal capillaries will vasodilate. That's why you might appear flushed or a little pink or a little red on the surface of the skin. That's because the vessels are dilating to release heat. Conversely, the dermal capillaries can vasoconstrict, meaning they narrow, and that prevents heat loss. All of that leads to the maintenance of a nice, normal, homeostatic body temperature. Piggybacking on that function, excretion of sweat is an important function of the skin. And not only does it cool your body, but it also releases some materials like urea, salts, water. All of that is part of excretion. Another important function is vitamin D production. In the presence of UV light, the cells of your outer layer of your skin, the keratinocytes, will synthesize vitamin D, which is actually a hormone. And that hormone will promote the absorption of calcium from the digestive tract. So it's a very important process, this exposure to UV light, vitamin D synthesis, and then the absorption of calcium from the GI tract. Your discussion for this module talks about the importance of vitamin D production, the evolution of something called melanin that protects the skin. So you will explore this concept in the discussion assignment for this module. Our last function is called sensory reception. Within the skin, not only the dermis, but also the epidermis, there are receptors that respond to various stimuli. Those stimuli could be touch, deep touch or gentle touch, temperature like an ice cube versus a hot cloth, pressure, vibration, and a very important stimulus or a very important sensation, pain. We need to be aware of our environment so that if you feel cold, your skin will detect that, and then there will be some physiological feedbacks. All of these functions are important to the integumentary system.